Ladies and gentlemen, this is the moment we have all been waiting for. This is the main event of the evening. 10 rounds in a super featherweight contest. It's all courtesy of Conlon Boxing in association with Top Rank Promotions. Coming to you live on Fight TV and ESPN+. This contest is sanctioned by the British Boxing Board of Control. Our officials ringside, John Williamson, MBE, and board rep Robert W. Smith. Your three judges scoring ringside, Mark Lyson from Liverpool, John Latham from Bury, and Kevin Parker from Nottingham. Your referee in charge of the action, Victor Loughlin from Paisley, Glasgow. And your timekeeper, Dale Elliott. Officially weighing in at 126.4 pounds. He brings to the ring a professional record of 30 wins, 5 losses, with 26 of those wins coming by way of knockout. Wearing red and blue shorts from Arona, Colombia, representing All-Star Boxing, please welcome Miguel the Scorpion Madariaga. And now, introducing his opponent across the ring in the blue corner. Officially weighing in at 127.9 pounds, he brings to the ring a professional record of 16 wins, only one loss. 8 of those wins coming by way of knockout. Tonight, wearing maroon and green shorts, standing with trainer Adam Booth. He is a former WBA world title challenger, 2012 Olympic bronze medal winner. Give his final instructions to the boxer.
Okay, chaps, you know the rules. Remember, obey my commands at all time. Defend yourselves at all time. God bless. Touch them. Good luck.
All right, here we go. Our main event. This one's scheduled for 10 rounds in the featherweight division. The return of Irish Mick Michael Conlon, coming off the only loss in his professional career. A knockout victory for Lee Wood in the last 90 seconds of that fight. Can Michael Conlon get back in the win column and cement himself a spot once again at a world title at 126 pounds? Or can Miguel Madariaga, the veteran with a ton of experience and a ton of power, put a halt to that world title quest? I'm Christina Poncher, joined by Jamel Herring.
And you see right from the get-go, what does Conlon do? Comes out southpaw, just like he said he would do.
Conlon told us he looks to fight exclusively southpaw, though he can switch and started much of his career in the orthodox stance. Since getting with Adam Booth, they just feel that this is where he's best suited in that southpaw stance. Madariaga looking to wing that right hand wildly. Madariaga feels that Conlon will not be 100% confident coming into this fight, and he wants to take advantage of that. He, though, is coming off a loss, Jamel.
And I like it, though, how Conlon, he's already come out with a bounce and a pep in his step. You know, he seems like he's warm, fresh, relaxed in there. And a minute ago, you know, you see Madariaga just, you know, kind of lunge and reach. He has to be patient. He can't rush him, you know, because a guy like Mick Conlon, he's going to be smooth and slick in there, so you can't rush him.
You see the Olympic rings tattooed on the right side of Michael Conlon, a two-time Irish Olympian, and a slip there.
Check hook, though.
He did land a punch at the same time, but called a slip by the referee. A clash of two styles, though, here, Jamel, really, when it comes down to these two. Mick really wanting to box in this fight. Mariaga prefers a war.
I was about to say that. Remember, he said yesterday that he knows that Colin is a boxer in the movement, and he said he doesn't like that. So, you know what fight he'd rather prefer. He'd rather prefer, you know, Colin staying in one place. But Mick being a smart boxer, he knows not to give it away or risk, you know, especially coming up a knockout loss, risk getting hit by something big from Mariaga.
And in that knockout loss, I mean, he says, I was a minute and a half away from winning a world title. He fought very well in that extremely entertaining fight against Lee Wood. And he said, you know, the knockout looked worse than it was because of how I fell out of the ring. But it was due to my own fatigue. I was never hurt earlier in that fight. The flash knockdown, I pretty much dominated that fight. And I don't want people to think I took a complete beating for 12 rounds and I'm coming in here a battered fighter. He caught me with a good shot and I just didn't have my legs under me.
And that's a great way to look at things, but also that last shot still doesn't matter how you describe it or cut it. It put the finishing touch on that fight.
And he took three big ones before the one that finished him. So here, starting cautious, but a good shot to the body there with the left hand.
Yep. Straight left hand down to the body.
That pace favoring the pace Conlin and his team prefer.
Yeah, more of a fill-out round. But again, yeah, Mariaga, you know, he has to watch out from overexerting himself and reaching like that. That's how he got caught with that.
It kind of cuffed him behind the head.
It kind of cuffed him, but it was more of his wrongdoing and momentum that set them down to the pavement like that. Him reaching out.
Michael Conlin telling us, quote, I want a dominant boxing performance, end quote. I emphasize that because earlier in his career, particularly under the tutelage of Manny Robles, he was in a lot of wars, a lot of entertaining scraps, throwing a little more caution to the wind. And since then, and since getting with Adam Booth, they worked a lot more on his boxing, his hit and knock and hit. And then, of course, as you mentioned, Jamel fighting out of that southpaw stance.
Right.
Round two scheduled for 10. Christina Poncher and Jamel Herring here with you. Thank you for joining us wherever you're watching around the world.
Like you mentioned, shout out to my guy Manny Robles. I know he's out watching.
Of course, always supporting him.
He's still a huge supporter of Mick Conlin.
Mariaga.
Conlin, you know,
standing.
He's being smart.
Waiting.
He's,
yep.
Using his distance and range. But again, you see right there, Mariaga. He's reaching. Instead of using his own jab and to inch closer to Conlin to get those big shots off, he's at a range that does him no benefits.
Looking to shoot that right uppercut as Conlin lunges in with that lead right jab.
But you notice that Conlin, he stepped over to the side, he stepped over to his right to avoid Mariaga's right uppercut and right hand altogether.
Sure did. And
just like that,
brought his body down real low. Getting away from those power shots of Mariaga.
And yeah, in the way he's doing it, even though at times Conlin is reaching himself, he gets low to where he can weave and dip under whatever Mariaga throws back at him.
There he landed a solid left hand on Mariaga. Mariaga continues to stand his ground, not having success landing really any punches thus far.
He's waiting. He's doing a lot of waiting. If I was Mariaga, I probably would try to apply a little bit more pressure. You're not gonna beat Mick Conlin at a chess match and a boxing match.
Excellent point. And that's not Miguel Mariaga's, style anyway. He's got to press the action and get Conlin off his back foot, or on his back foot, excuse me.
I mean, he said yesterday that he wants to make Mick Conlin feel like that it was a mistake to fight him. But so far, you know, he's giving Mick a pass. Even though it was only the second round, like he hasn't done much of anything so far.
And especially when you want to catch a fighter, right, coming off a knockout loss, want to test him, want to see where they're confident. Exactly. Go early. That you would think that would be to your advantage to press the action early and test his confidence.
Exactly. You want to break that confidence early, and you want to implement your will. So you give your opponent something to really think about and start second guessing and questioning himself.
Few. Range finding jabs there coming from Conlin. Small feints the body under 30 seconds left now in round two. Stab bang, with the left hand down to the body.
And again, like you pointed out, this is the pace that Mick Conlon wants to fight at. If he can get one or two here, he's got.
Mariaga got one in there.
Yeah, one in it. But if he could just get one or two there, without worrying about, you know, what's coming back from Mariaga, he's gonna cruise this entire fight. There again, Mariaga just getting wild.
Mick Conlon taking on Miguel Mariaga, and even fighters like Carl Frampton, when I was reading kind of the lead up to the fight, said, you know, he kind of would have got a pass if he would have taken on maybe a little bit less aggressive, hard-hitting opponent in a comeback fight after a loss. But it was so important for Mick to show that he is a world-class threat, that he didn't want to pick an easy fighter. He didn't want a quote-unquote comeback, you know, a layup fight, if you will. And he wants more than anything, though, a rematch against Lee Wood. He said, I would take that fight tomorrow if I could.
Yeah,
That's sitting with him, and it's killing him.
And I asked him also as well, you know, depending how tomorrow goes, tonight, you know, what do you want next? And just like you mentioned, though, that he took this type of fight because he wants to get right back into that title picture. It doesn't matter. You know, he obviously wants that rematch, but he's up to fight any of the other world champions as well.
I mean, I'd even like to see him fight like Josh Warrington, even if he's not. I mean, Navarrete and Ray Vargas, and then you got Dogman and Mandatory. There's a lot kind of going on there at the top. But if not that Lee Wood, I mean, there's still some good fights to be made, but he's got his hands full tonight with Miguel Mariaga, who looks like,
he's tense.
You know,
he's tight. He just looks so tight. Yeah.
Exactly what I was going to say, Jamel. He just looks really tight so far. Hasn't been able to get in any sort of rhythm and let his hands go. Those fluid body shots that we're used to seeing from him. Not one yet.
Yeah, not one. He's looking for the right hand. Whether he'll bring it down to the body of Mick Conlon, or he'll try to wing it with a huge overhand right at times. But when he's doing it, he's not setting anything up with a jab. Right now, you know, he's putting it out there, but he's not really committing to his jab if you look closely. It's just out there. It's just more of a range finder for him. Mariaga, at least.
Conlon landing a good right hand there, and then just as you mentioned earlier, he did a good job of slipping.
Yeah.
Under getting his head low enough to avoid any damage from a counter from Mariaga. Steps forward.
And he has to watch how he's doing that, because you don't want to swing your head into the momentum of his head, and then now we got a clash, you know, a clash of heads, somebody's cut. Nice check up from Mick Conlon, though. Good left hand.
He came with some power behind that left hand there, did Conlon. Mariaga gets a warning to keep his punches up.
Well, for the most part, Mick Conlon's doing basically touch and don't get hit. You know what I mean? He's cool with just landing one here and one there. And that's because Mariaga isn't throwing anything back, so he can get away with just, you know, with a low output and also steal the round. But he has to watch out for that swinging, for that looping left hand that we've been seeing a lot tonight from a lot of fighters, you know, instead of them just like throwing it straight down the middle.
Absolutely. That lead right hand connected well. And then he comes back with the left down to the body, right on that belt line of Mariaga.
Smart. He'll catch Mariaga up, you know, to get his attention up top. Mariaga will put his hands up, and then he'll throw that straight left hand to the body of Mariaga afterwards. But for the most part, Mick Conlon is going in the right direction, meaning he's avoiding Mariaga's right hand. And his foot is on the outside of Mariaga, so that's why. I mean, you have to carefully look at that, and that's why I feel like Mariaga is falling in, whereas Mick can counter with either a right uppercut or a straight right hand, because because Mariaga is falling directly on the inside of Mick Conlon's lead foot.
Another solid round in the bank for Mike Conlon, and he says, you know what? I'm okay if the crowd boos me. I'm okay if people don't like my style of fighting now, but it's hit and not get hit.
Right.
I'm trying to continue and have longevity in my career. I'm trying to raise my kids. I want to be able to talk to them without, you know, stuttering. I want to be able to be there for my family. And so if this adjustment that he's had to make is what suits him best, and Adam Booth is happy, and he said, that's all I need to worry about.
Exactly. I mean, a great quote that he made yesterday was, you know, I don't care about being in Fighter of the Year if I, you know, if I'm losing, pretty much. You know what I mean? Like, it's the truth. It doesn't really mean much. Yes, it's a great honor in terms of an accomplishment, you know, to be in Fighter of the Year, but if you're on a losing end, it doesn't really do you much justice.
Well, and he was. I mean, that fight against Lee Wood back in March was an incredible fight. It was an extremely entertaining fight. But it's a fight that he got knocked down. It says, for 2 weeks nonstop, Christina, I thought about that. I was in complete and utter disbelief about how close I was to my dream and my opportunity with that regular title, world title, and it slipped away from him. So that still weighs on him. And he wants to get back to fighting more of his fight. A lot of upper body movement there from Conlon, kind of just pawing out with that right hand jab.
And if you watch also, he kind of has Mariaga mesmerized. What I mean by that is, he has Mariaga, you know, basically second guessing himself. He's not making the first move. He's biting and falling into all of McCollin's bait and traps.
Which is why he's able to land that right hand at will, too, right? When
exactly.
He kind of gets him to lean in with some of those feints, or maybe just throwing that left, he tags him with the right hand.
Nice defense from McCollin with that maneuver. And all he's doing is just turning. He's just turning, meaning that he just, you know, constantly turning to his right as the fight goes on. Instead of exerting so much energy and moving all over around the ring, all you gotta do is just turn him and keep a jab in his face, and you can easily win the fight with just basics. What I don't like is when Mick at times swings his head around, because he can to potentially set himself up to get hit with a headbutt. But for the most part, Mariaga isn't doing much because he's too mesmerized and just standing there stuck.
Yeah, has not had any sort of fluidity to his offense whatsoever. Gets into one good shot here and there, just like Mariaga did with that right hand to the body there. There's nothing else coming behind it.
And he just falls in.
And Conlon catches him with the left, falling in.
He shoots over his lead foot, and he falls right into Mick Conlon. And Mick Conlon just
shooting now around
Mick,
the
now
guard.
Mick is feeling it. Yeah, now Mick is he's feeling it. He's feeling like he can do whatever he wants. Watching here is more of a cat and mouse, for sure, definitely. But Mick Conlon is making it look real easy, and this is basically
down to the body. Great body shot there from Conlon.
Got the crowd's reaction with that.
Miguel Mariaga having a very difficult time getting any sort of offense started on Mick Conlon, waiting, in fact, for Conlon to throw, for him to unleash his punches. And they've often been like a right hand to the body like he did there, but that's not winning him any of these rounds.
Mick is trying to sneak in that crafty right uppercut.
Or the right hand to the body, and it's just not enough. And those
freezing,
are just more
just
rounds in the bank.
He's just freezing them up. Slide out. That's what I meant by turning. Slide out and turn. Good body attack from Mick Conlon. Counter shots. Sneaky right uppercut followed with a hook up top from Mick Conlon.
How does Miguel Mariaga get his offense started?
He has to be the aggressor. He has to start applying effective pressure. He just sitting back. He Mick Conlon clearly is the longer rangier fighter, the more natural pure boxer, and it's like, you know, Mariaga, he's sitting back. trying to box with a boxer who's longer and taller than him. He needs to get in Mick Collins' chest and start moving forward instead of, you know, turning into the circle, because all he's doing is allowing Collins to be the dance partner and lead the way in terms of the way the rhythm is going in the fight. Now he just sitting back right now. He should be using his jab, of course, to come forward, but keep inching little by little while applying effective aggression in the same instance.
Like keep touching. At least start trying to get into the rhythm.
Something in his face. It doesn't have to be any hard, but keep your man busy and on alert. Right now you're just allowing Mick Collins just to pick shots, turn, do whatever, slip out. Every now and then throw a right hand to the body and so, but Marjak, what has he done so far? But react over what Mick Collins is doing. He hasn't done much of anything. But go in a circle. To his left.
Slightly pawing out the jab now is Mariaga.
I know for those at home watching, probably saying that this isn't a very entertaining fight, but for me, it's a smart fight that Mick Collins is fighting, and it takes two to tangle, meaning that Mariaga isn't doing much of anything to make this fight, you know, interesting or intriguing. Oh.
Conlin staying disciplined, sticking to the game plan, working off the jab, shooting some shots down to the body of Mariaga, but very comfortable. I mean, I know part of the problems for Mick Conlin comes when he's up against the ropes, but he's just, even though Mariaga's more on the center of the ring, he's not of any risk because he's not letting his hands go. So Conlin very comfortable right now moving along the outside.
Mariaga, he just lost and doesn't know what to do. And you could, and just from that a few moments ago, you could clearly see in his face that he was a bit frustrated. He mentioned yesterday that he doesn't like to go find boxers. He'd rather just fight and bang.
Mariaga trying to land some to the body, but Conlin again gets in a right body shot when Mariaga finally does open up, and that's probably why he hasn't done it much.
Right.
Stab jab down to the body from Conlin.
Stick and move.
Good combination, and then right back out. Great footwork there, working a great angle to end the round. More of the same.
It's not broken, why fix it? That sneaky left hand. I mean, he got hit.
And that's probably why Miguel isn't letting his hands go. Like I said, the minute he lets his hands go, he gets tagged with a shot to the body.
Right. Boom. It's been all night. The left hand to the body, followed by a right hook up top to the head. How deep from the column right there? But that's what Mariaga wants to match against the ropes. You see, the Mick Collins seen where he was at and instantly reached out and grabbed him to tie up.
I'd love to hear what they told Mariaga in the corner, but hopefully it's, you need to step up and let your hands go. We're halfway through the fight and he does not have a round in the bank.
Not even close.
Michael Conlin continuing to stick to his game plan, true to form, working off the jab, landing some good shots to the body, hit and not get hit. Can't get hit if your opponent doesn't throw punches, but still.
A lot of trainers probably watching Mariaga and highly upset with his footwork, because even when he throws that right hand, he's taking his back foot off the ground, which takes away power from those punches. And it also leaves you in a bad situation because you're off balance and you're leaving yourself susceptible to get countered and get hit with something big.
Yeah, all that power comes from your base. It comes from your feet.
But he's so desperate just to touch him that he's not even paying attention to his fundamentals right now.
Another shot to the body from Conlin. That one again with a straight left hand to the gut.
And again, Mick isn't, he hasn't really thrown a lot of punches, but he's keeping Mariaga so mesmerized and just, you know, busy with just his movement, his upper body movement. He doesn't know if he's going to throw a punch, if he's going to throw, if he's going to faint, or if he's going to move, or what.
There again, that shot.
Nice shot.
It's been there for him all night. There he brings it back up to the top.
But that's the rhythm and pattern he's been doing all night. Colin, he'll throw something into your body to make Mayorga lower his hands and his guard, and he'll quickly throw right back up top with a left hand, either a straight left or that looping left hand shot behind the ear. That's probably one of the first shots that we've seen on Mayorga hit Colin.
And it just kind of grazed his head there.
Yeah. But Nick goes right back to the game plan, puts the fight right back in the center of the ring, boxes a bit. And it got a little bit wild there. Yeah, but you still have to watch out for that, because Mayorga still has that. He still could be dangerous. He still carries power.
And there's another slip there. And, you know, Conlon telling us leading up to the fight, he's like, I expect Mayorga to keep up a good work rate. I expect him, you know, to still punch hard like he has done his entire career. But he hasn't really brought any of that tonight. Right. Nothing of concern thus far from Mick Conlon. Not even that work rate he expected, which very much so plays right into what Conlon wants to do.
Right. And again, I'm sure he still has some power behind those punches, but like you mentioned, he's not bringing the work rate, at least. He's not, Mayorga hasn't brought the work rate at all in this fight so far. It's more been about what Conlon wants to do.
Would you like to see Conlon maybe put on a little bit more pressure at this point? Are you fine with this pace from him?
I'm actually fine with this pace because, again, you don't know what he's going through mentally. I mean, just look at the last fight. He was winning the last fight clearly, and then the last 30 seconds of the fight, you know, things turned around. So of course you gotta take things like that into consideration.
Sure. And he admitted that it was fatigue that really did get to him at the end of that.
Because he exerted so much out, like he said.
Sure. Unlike he's having to do this evening.
Yeah, you know, it's like one here, two shots to deal on tops. But, you know, they're reaching their mark and they're landing. And again, right there, I think Mayorga is just, his footing has been awful this fight, that his balance hasn't been there.
Yeah, just really not true to form of what we expect from Miguel Mayorga. But kudos also to Michael Conlon, who is doing a good job defensively.
Neutralizing it.
Exactly. But there's got to be a little bit more sense of urgency now for Miguel Mayorga. Round 7, this one scheduled for 10. Christina Poncher and Jamel Herring here with you. Pair of featherweights. Michael Conlon looking to get a victory tonight and get right back in the conversation, if not for a rematch against Lee Wood. Perhaps another fight against a ranked opponent to get him in contention for a world title. Featherweight is where he wants to be and where he aspires to win a world title.
And we asked Mayorga yesterday, due to the fact that he's in Belfast, can he win by boxing or does he need a knockout? And he felt that he could do either one, even though he wants to go for the knockout. But right now, he definitely hasn't done any, well, he's been losing the chess match battle, clearly. But right now, in round 7, you know, I feel like he definitely needs a knockout or a few knockdowns.
For sure. And I mean, he's used to fighting in enemy territory, and perhaps maybe now on the latter part of his career at 35 years old, and with the amount of fights that he has had, this fight number 36, relying a little bit more on his power and hoping that he can land a shot that will change things. And as we've seen against Mick Conlon, I guess he is susceptible to that.
Right. I mean, for both right now, Mayorga, he's trying, he's pushing forward, but again, that's all. He was off balance, but it was a punch. No, it was a punch.
It's a knockdown scored for Conlon in round 7. Mayorga didn't like the call.
It was a punch.
I'm sure we'll see a couple replays, but definitely a punch thrown there. Although Mayorga feels it's more of a slip.
Yeah, the first one I believe was off, but I know the second one landed, and that's probably what the referee's seen as well. Even though we clearly seen that Mariaga's momentum is what led to that knockdown, but at the end of the day, the rules are, you know, it was a punch that landed.
Conlon scores a knockdown here in round seven, under a minute left to go.
Strong jab from Conlon. Stab the body man.
Mariaga looking for that home run shot with those signature body hooks that have been obsolete in this fight, to say the least. Little rough housing here from Mariaga as he tries to finally engage Conlon. Conlon back to the center of the ring, working off the jab.
Yeah, Mariaga definitely has that sense of urgency. And any time when a fighter feels out, when he gets a knockdown, that he felt that it wasn't a knockdown, they get up and really, you don't feel like they have to make up for that.
Right, get back, right? Conlon's been able to land that straight left hand to the body at will.
And he's mixed it up. I like that. He's mixed it up a lot well.
Yeah, he's brought it back up top too. And again, shutout performance from Conlon. And that's a good shot there, with leading with the left hand. Here is the exchange with him and Mariaga, where he was off balance there in that lunging shot forward. But let's take a look at the one that was considered a knockdown. I don't think we're going to see it right here, but
he jumped. I felt like Mariaga jumped into it. Boom, he jumped.
Okay, so there was a shot on the second half of it, but that first shot looked like it was on the back, grazing on the back of his head.
Yeah, the back, okay, yeah.
So, knockdown scored, but I don't feel like the initial damage was done by a punch. That was a good shot, that left hand there.
That's just bad footwork that we've been seeing all night from Mariaga, though. And I knew it was just, and I mentioned that it's a matter of time before a fighter either trips up because of, you know, they're not paying attention where their feet are at, and bad footwork and rhythm. He dove right into that.
Well, and he just dove himself into a deeper hole now, because that's a 10-8 round scored for Conlon in a fight that he's pretty much won every round. So without a doubt, Mariaga needs a knockout at this point to win this fight.
And one thing I want to mention is that compared to the last fight, at least, Mick Conlon's stamina looks a lot better, even though he hasn't had much output because he doesn't need it. But at the same time, I know mentally he's probably feeling good about himself going into these later rounds from his last fight. The check hook, it's been there all night.
And there it is again.
And these are the rounds you would expect Mariaga to have more sense of urgency. Right now, he just plowing forward, just, you know, swinging for whatever he can hit instead of setting things up.
And Mariaga himself has had 8 months out of the ring, but for a fighter of his caliber, the way he fights, the amount of fights that he's had, he said, you know, the rest was good for his body. He needed that. But right now, it has me thinking that he's a little bit gun shy. I don't know if he was thinking that he was going to save some of that energy towards the end of the fight, but At this point, right now, he needs to get busy.
I'm thinking that he was probably thinking that Mick Conlon was going to come in the fight gun-shy because of his last outing. And it's a totally different fight that he expected. Because he was very confident now coming into this fight.
And there's a good left hand, doubles it up with Conlon, and then they both embrace here. It's under a minute and a half left in round eight.
That left hand to the body's been there all night from McCollum.
I mean, it's been thrown even on his straight line. It's as if there's a bullseye on the stomach of Mariaga. And there is another knockdown scored as he gets the count once again.
I got to look at that one. I know it was a sequence of punches there, but kind of looked like he tripped over the little logo.
Right, and that's what I'm not sitting here, knocked down, because granted, yes, we are looking at a monitor too, like from a studio, but nonetheless, these look like slips. We get another look at it, and you're like, oh yeah, it was. But the referee's standing right there in front of him, and knocked down in round seven, he calls, knocked down here in round eight.
Now, if you look at Mariaga, his stance, it's not the best right now in terms of if that canvas is slippery, because his feet are real wide. And every time he tries to throw that right hand, he lifts, like again, he lifts his back foot off the ground and places him in a bad position where he's off balance. You know, and right now, Conlon's just feeling it. He's just feeling good right now.
Mariaga gets in one right hand to the body in that combination, but Mick Conlon walks him right back to the center of the ring. And again, we'll take a look at that. No benefit of instant replay there, but that knockdown, again, in round eight, not a clear knockdown that we could see.
Left into the body all night.
He actually caught Conlon with a right hand there.
Left into the body all night.
And those are right on the belt line. He hits him with the right that maybe for a second looked like it made his legs weak, but the actual shot that they called a knockdown.
Credit to Collins' defense, though. You know, he's slipping, he's weaving out the way.
Yeah, and I mean, Miguel was punching as he was moving forward, and just literally his leg slipped on that, probably on that logo right there, and yet it's called a knockdown. But that was a dominant round nonetheless from Mick Conlon, and probably the way his legs turned made it look like maybe they were affected from a punch.
Right.
But knockdown scored in round seven, knockdown scored in round eight, and here we are, the penultimate round, round nine. And it's just more of the same. I think Conlon maybe is going to turn it up a tad here. I just have this feeling, kind of the way he looked at Mariaga at the end of that last round. He kind of gave him like a come on type look. IQ maybe wants him to engage a little bit more.
But for the most part, he is sticking with the game plan, Mick Conlon, which is his box, turn, move, popping the jab here and there, go to the body.
And if what he told us, and I said it at the beginning of the show, a dominant boxing performance, then check, check, and check. That's exactly what he's delivered this evening, and that's what he wanted. He didn't say an entertaining fight. He didn't say it's going to be a war. He didn't say it's going to be a slugfest. I'm going to knock him out. None of those things. Slipping all over the place. Mind you, there has been about 10 fights on the bill this evening. Those mats, the logos and stuff, that does get slippery, but Miguel Mariaga just hasn't had his solid legs under him all night. He's still lifting up on the foot when he throws punches. That was a shot that had a delayed reaction. That was clear, despite his disapproval. Under a minute and a half to go, down to the body goes Conlon.
Mick Conlon's selling right now.
And the crowd is egging on the hometown fighter out of Belfast.
Good body shots from Mick Conlon on both sides.
Go to the body, bring the hands down.
I feel like he's baiting it. I feel like he's baiting Mariaga with the jump into something again. But that's been Mariaga's issue this whole fight. Being off balance, jumping into shots.
And slips almost right there.
Yeah,
again,
exactly.
That back right
he's,
foot.
He's so desperately trying to get to Mick Conlon now that he's not watching where he's at.
Down to the body goes Conlon.
Oh.
Nice hooks from Mick Conlon, slipping that shot in.
Yeah, he's
telling you. He's sliding all over the place. Maybe he needs some better shoes, too.
Maybe.
Nonetheless, that shouldn't, you should still be letting your hands go.
He's going to turn. Touch and turn. Mick Conlon.
And a cut now. Looks like blood streaming down the left side of the temple of Conlon, I thought I saw.
Oh.
Now have to get another look at that, but it looked maybe it was just a piece of his hair. It was really hard to see here on the monitor, but
I know what you're looking at. I didn't know if that was hair or
I thought there was a cut right there by the left ear. I mean, doesn't it look like they're working on something there? Yeah, see, there's blood on that gauze.
Okay.
There is some sort of cut, not in a place that should bother him much.
He's hit every corner of that ring tonight, I swear. But that was an official knockdown. He got lined up.
And we come to the 10th and final round as they get that cleared up. Mouthpiece back in, 3 minutes away from getting back into the win column for Michael Conlan, and would be three losses then in the last four fights for Miguel Mariaga, who at 35 years old may think about what he wants to do moving forward. But what he wants to do is move forward and try any and everything that he can to try to knock out Mick Conlan. That's his only chance for a win this evening.
Sliding all over the ring, trying. He has to be smart while doing it, though, at the same time. And watch where their feet are, because I know they both been stepping on each other's feet as well. You watch the feet.
Oh. Now he wants to make it rough, and Conlan trying to hold, Miguel trying to free himself.
Martin, he needs to jump back on Mick Conlan ASAP.
You hear this urgency coming from the Mariaga corner, encouraging their man to come on, but they should have been doing that much earlier on in the fight. Now Miguel Mariaga throwing a left hook to the body. There's some of the hooks we expected to see. Conlan looking to hold.
I don't know. I don't want to say it, but it seems like these last rounds are Conlan's kryptonite at times, I swear.
Down to the body goes Conlan. Back again to the body with the right hand. But still, he scores a knockdown in rounds eight and round nine. So.
I believe it was three, matter of fact.
Yeah, he scored a knockdown also round seven. So seven, eight, and nine.
But he's well ahead.
Most of them look like slip. None of them was detrimental to Mariaga in terms of pain or punishment, but in terms of the scorecard.
Well, where was
absolutely.
He at the whole fight, though? Where was his at? This is the most we've seen him go to the body in his last round.
Just under a minute left.
Veteran move from Mick Conlan, put him in the headlock when the referees are looking to get a quick breather.
50 seconds now to go. Conlan is standing more stagnant, Jamel, to your point, in this last round than he has.
Back. Now he's pushing forward.
Trying to fight back.
Now he's fighting.
But that gives Mariaga a sliver of an opportunity. But now he's got Mariaga in some trouble. Down to the body. Mariaga shoots an uppercut with the left hand.
20 seconds left. A little rough start this round from Mick Conlan, but he's closing out. Closing really strong. And now I start to see that blush that you mentioned streaming on his left side.
And he will backpedal at this point.
Maybe one
more shot for good measure as Mariaga with a flurry of punches ends this one. But nonetheless, a dominant boxing performance from Irish Mick Conlan, getting him back in the win column after suffering the first loss of his career, as his coach Adam Booth with some last minute words before he goes over to the Mariaga corner. And it's kind of the end of the fight here. I mean, Mariaga threw more punches, Jamel, in the last round than he did the entire nine rounds before that.
And I just wish we were seeing more of that throughout the fight, but overall, I felt like it was a good performance from Mick Conlan. I believe he's going to definitely get the win tonight and get back on track in terms of becoming a world champion.
That left hand, the straight left to the body, was there all night. Brought it back up top, worked solid off the jab. There's the right to the body. I mean, he stuck to what worked for the majority of the fight, got the job done, got a couple of knockdowns that looked like slip. The one in the ninth round was probably the most clear as far as seeing a punch and then a reaction.
Left.
Little uppercut gets in from Mariaga there.
See Conlan, you know, smart, just holding on.
His brother, Jamie Conlan, ecstatic. As he knew how much to getting into the ring, putting that loss behind you, moving forward. This has to feel good for the Conlan family, as there's his daughter, Luis Ney, and his son, Michael Jr.
Like I said, those are his biggest fans and cheerleaders.
Absolutely. embracing his fellow fighters, some of the undercard guys that have made their way ringside to support their fellow Irishman and manager too, mind you. Him and Jamie both run Conlon Boxing there. Yep. We're just waiting for the official decision from Terry Cavanaugh. As Miguel Mariaga and Mick Conlon embrace there at the center of the ring, but I am slightly disappointed from what we saw tonight from Miguel Mariaga. Let's make this one official first and then more on this fight. Here's Terry Cavanaugh.
Ladies and gentlemen, please show your appreciation for both fighters. What a fight! After 10 great rounds, we go to the judges' scorecards. Both judges, Mark Lyson and Kevin Parker, have it 99-88. And Judge Sean Latham scores the bout 99-89. All in favor of your winner by unanimous decision, Michael Conlon!
And just as we thought, a unanimous decision sweeping every round. And then, of course, the three knockdowns on the scorecards from the slip, but a very solid performance for him, a get back performance, a stuck to the game plan, stay very disciplined, which was the goal, and overall, you know, a dominating performance, and that's what he wanted.
He did what he had to do, simple as that. Like you mentioned, more importantly, he listened to his team, his corner, he stuck with the game plan, he boxed beautifully. I wouldn't say he had a scare in that last round. I mean, he may have got caught, but at the end of the day, he fought back and he controlled it, and I felt that he did great.
I was hoping for a little bit more from Miguel Mariaga. I've covered a ton of his fights throughout his career. This is probably the least amount of punches he's ever thrown in a fight, but give some kudos to Mick Conlon, too, for not really standing in there and banging with him and making it into the fight that Miguel Mariaga wanted. He did not make it easy for him at all. So when you look at the other fighters at the 126 featherweight division, guys like Ray Vargas, guys like Warrington, Navarrete, obviously at the top of that list for me, I know I can bet my house on the fact that he wants that rematch no matter what with Lee Wood first, but then a world title shot. I mean, do you see him being competitive? And who, if you could choose, aside from the rematch, maybe, would you like to see him fight?
I think, honestly, Mick Conlon could be competitive with any of those world champions. As long as he continues to do what he did tonight, which is follow his game plan, box beautifully and listen, you know, and also continue training where the stamina issues will be behind him for, you know, as he moves further along in his career, he'll be fine against either one of those guys. So I'm not really worried about that. I just wanted to really see, you know, what he would do tonight and how he would react mentally to everything he's been through from his last fight till tonight.
Yeah, and that was one of your questions, right, coming into it. Every time we let up, you say, where would his mind be at? How does would he come off gun shy? How would he perform? So do you feel like he answered some of those questions?
Opposite from Mariaga, it seemed like he was more gun-shy than Mick Conlon. Mick Conlon came out with full of confidence and ready to go.
Yeah, it was kind of opposite of what we thought. He said he made a mistake choosing him. And in fact, he played right into the game plan of Team Conlon. Okay, we're awaiting an interview from Ali Drew in the ring with Mick Conlon as she gets ready to move herself in there after the victory photographs. We'll get a chance to hear from Mick, and then we'll close this one up. All right, here's Ali with Mick.
Michael Conlon, back to winning ways. How important was that for you tonight?
It was very important, very important. And you know what? I couldn't have done it without this fantastic crew. Unbelievable tonight, unbelievable. For everybody on the card. I came in earlier when I came in and I heard the atmosphere and I was like, fuck me, that's loud. And there's only half of the arena here. So the fact the full arena, unbelievable support. So thank you to everybody who came.
Now, that was a tough 10 rounds. Mariaga was a tough opponent. You were both on the canvas at various points.
No, it wasn't.
You slipped. There was a lot of water, I think. But how tough was that to get through 10 rounds?
You know what? I had to get rid of a lot of demons tonight. Even in the fucking last round, you know, he hit me a shot. That guy can punch 10 more knockouts than I had faith. So he hit me a jab in the first round. I was like, oh, this guy actually can bang. So I had to be careful and use my skills, which I did. And in the last round, he caught me a shot. I was listening, I've been using my legs all night. I was a bit off the pace, he was pushing it. He landed a good shot. He buckled me a little bit, I felt it. And for me, to kind of come through that, and it's the last round, I got knocked out my last fight in the last round. I think that says a lot. I'm back, baby. I'm ready for any of them.
What instructions was Adam giving you in the corner between those rounds?
Be calm, stop trading. You don't need to use your skills. You have so much energy, everything. Just refrain on what we've worked on in camp. And, you know, he's the best coach in the world, in my opinion. And tonight, you know, he kept a cool head on my shoulders. And he may be disappointed I had a little bit of a go in the last round. But, you know, I think I showed enough of that. How, you know, I knuckled down and I end up putting Mariaga on the back foot. So, yeah, it was good.
You had a great performance tonight. What are you wanting next?
I want Lee Wood. Obviously, it's obvious, but Lee's got his own situation, so hopefully he can deal with that and come through and the rematch can be done. But listen, if not, it's anybody else, any other champion. I want to get back in. I will be world champion, and I know I will, so whoever I face, I know I'll be.
A final word for the fans who have come out tonight and the ones watching from home.
My first word and my last words always go to the fans here. Unbelievable, like a crowd still over here. I think just looking over, they look like they're all from St. James's, so they're a bit crazy. But thank you to all these, everyone from all around Belfast, all around Ireland, people coming from Scotland and England, everywhere, anywhere you've travelled from. I appreciate it. My love and gratitude goes to you so much. So, you know, what a night. You know, we're back.
You're back to win away. Congratulations.
Cheers, Ollie. Thank you.
Well done, Ali Drew. Thank you for your interviews all night. And congratulations to Michael Mick Conlon. And just as you said, Jamel, he had those questions that he wanted to answer to himself. And he said, gosh darn it, I got hit again in that 10th round. He buckled me, but I needed mentally to get through something like that. And he did.
And he tied up. He tied up. He didn't try to fight fire with fire. He played it smart. And he left safely this time without a scare. So much credit to Mick Conlon, man. I'm happy to see him back, and I'm pretty sure there's a lot of great things in his future to come.
Looking forward to him on the quest for a world title. We've been there since day one, and the journey continues for Michael Mick Conlon. Jamel Herring, excellent job on the mic tonight. I really appreciated your analysis and your commentary. Thank you for joining me.
I appreciate you.
All right, for Jamel Herring, Marty Corwin, our entire crew in the truck, I'm Christina Poncher. Thank you for watching. We'll see you next time.